So we started goal. Goals and goal setting. So what are goals? What is the role of goals in personal development of a person in the success of a person? See, when you construct a building also, we have some plot, something, and then you build on it, no? So goals are the building blocks of success. Without goals, you leave success to chance. Goals, well-defined goals, just goals is not enough, followed by adequate
action.
That is important. Action, timely, adequate, enthusiastic, confident action that leads to success or to achievement, to accomplishment, whatever you want to say. Jim Lawrence says that without goals, success is not attainable. Because success itself is attainment of goal. So, what is success now? What is success to you? Success kya hota?
If your desires manifest.
No, can you be more specific? What? If you become a millionaire, is that success?
No, what you really want, if it manifests as a desire, then it's success.
आपके बोल सक्सेस क्या है कम यस व्हाट इज सक्सेस टू यू
इट्स अ हैप्पीनेस इन लाइफ
हैप्पीनेस इन लाइफ इज सक्सेस टू यू व्हाट अबाउट यू सर व्हाट इज सक्सेस टू यू
सक्सेस मींस सर
अचीवमेंट ऑफ गोल ठीक है ओके अनीता व्हाट इज सक्सेस टू यू
सेम
Same. I could use some words. Use some different word. So success means different things to different people. Actually, for some name, if their name, they get the name in the paper every day, in the TV, they come, etc. They feel there is success. Okay? Mm-hmm. Some people want fame. Everybody all over the world, people mm-hmm. should know me. Okay, name, fame. Some people want money. If they find money, I'm successful. Some people who are sexually oriented, they feel they have the more sexual partners they have, the more successful they are. Okay? So some people have success is professional excellence. Mm. If I'm good in my profession and doing very well, that is success. Okay? So success is means different things to different things. Okay? Some people to Virat Kohli success will be
yes.
being an outstanding sportsman. Mm. Winning the IPL or scoring so many centuries in the IPL, loving it, right? To somebody, success might be becoming a good film star, Shah Rukh Khan, Sanjay Dutt, whatever it is, okay? So that is success for them. So you cannot just say this is success or this is success or this is success. Broadly what you have said is correct, and if you achieve your goals, it is success, okay? And where the goals will be, well, suppose you want to become a black marketer, can you call that a success?
No, sir.
Well, you are succeeding in your goal.
No, sir. But, sir,
Or a terrorist.
There should be ethical goal. There should be some ethics.
There should be some ethics.
If there is no peace of mind, then even if you achieve a goal, it is not
okay. So, it should be. So, that's a good point, isn't it? So your goals should be well defined, they should be ethical goals, they should not be against society or harmful to
others.
Terrorist, you cannot say he's a successful terrorist or he's a successful rapist, you can't say that. Okay.
Yeah, we may have so many goals, we have to select only important ones.
Whichever is important for you. And what is important for you may not be important for somebody else.
Yes, sir, the priority will be different.
And what is important for you today may change
tomorrow.
So your goals have to link up to that.
Why it changes?
So we all agree that goals are the building blocks of success. Okay, without goals you cannot succeed. And then success means different things to different people. So we'll give one definition of success. what shall I say? Success is a progressive realization of well-defined, worthwhile personal goals. Success is a progressive, see the word progressive realization. That means step by step you come. You overnight you don't become a famous film star, or overnight you don't become a famous cricket player. You progress slowly. So, okay? So success is a progressive, and this definition will apply to whatever may be your success. Okay? It will apply, this definition. Whatever your focus in life is, this is the definition which I feel is applicable to all. Progressive realization of well-defined personal goals. Okay. Right. Now, with this definition, you can also tailor success to your personal vision. Like you said, ethics, you know, with this definition you can. Okay. So that is clear in our mind about success. So let's go to next thing. The strongest force in motivation, human motivation, is our goal. That's the strongest. The goals give you what?
Inspiration.
Inspiration. Okay, what else? Come on, the small class, you can make it interactive, that is better. Goals give you meaning, purpose, focus.
Hope for tomorrow.
Hope for tomorrow, desire to achieve something. And goals, as you rightly said, you said about goals, so many goals are. But goals help you to concentrate on the important activities in your life. If you're sure where you want to go, when you have goals, means you know where you want to go, then you save a lot of time and energy. It's like this, I was asking, you know, where you are staying. So if I'm staying at my inn, okay. So if I'm clear, when I finish the talk at 4:30, go to my mind, go straight to my mind.
Focus is clear.
Focus is very clear. Okay. So otherwise you waste your time. There are people who spend hours reading the newspaper, oversleeping, watching TV. Now the full-time job is cell phone. Full-time job it is. Isn't it? So that is the importance of goal, that it helps you to concentrate on most important activities. It helps you to evaluate the various demands made on you. Somebody is telling you have to come for my wedding, somebody says you have to come for my child's birthday party, your boss is telling you got a meeting, you have to submit the paper, your brother is telling that you have to take me for a football match, and your girlfriend is Now, out of all these demands, you have to decide which are the useful demands, which are productive demands, and which you can eliminate from your list. So, goals help you to. When you are clear, I'm clear I have to go to mine, then why will I come with you to Grand Road? Otherwise, I will keep looking around here and there, Chaji, Vada Pav. Okay. So, all the unimportant pulls and pressures will get dissolved if you are clear, if you are focused on it. It is said, some writers on personal growth say, it is a tragic fact that there are billions of people in this world. I don't know, I think 7 billion is the same? I think it is 7 billion is the population. When I took this note down some years ago, it was 4 billion. But whatever it is in billions only. But only a small minority have clear-cut ideas about what they want to do, or they have got focus. The rest of the people are, most of 98 out of 100 persons who are dissatisfied with their life have no clear-cut goal about where they want to go, what they want to do. They have no goal of improving their life, which is very tragic. Okay? So, I'll give an example. They say, a research was taken where they interviewed or they talked to 100 captains of ships. Captains of ships, 100. That means 100 ships, 100 captains. And asked them where they will be 6 months from today. One of the important questions they always ask you in interviews, where do you see yourself 5 years from today, 3 years from today? So they ask them, where do you see yourself 6 months of today? Where will you be 6 months of today? Captain of ship. And interestingly, what happened, 97% of these captains were absolutely clear about where they would be. They were absolutely clear how far they will go, where they will be. The same question was put forward to management graduates of Boston University, which is one of the better universities in America. And surprisingly they say, or sadly, not surprisingly, sadly, 97% did not know where they would be. Okay. That's a very sad reflection. After spending so many years in a management institute and getting so much of input from so many people, internationally known people, this is what answer they give. Yeah. Okay. So we'll leave it at that. So what happens is, when you don't have goals, then there's something like, we have got this mall, you know, there are big departmental stores and malls in USA. Malls here is a new idea, but there is a thing called J.C. Penney in store. You heard? You've gone abroad in there? J.C. Penney is huge. So the CEO of J.C. Penney said, you give me, you know, they call them a stock clerk. You know, like salesmen, how they keep track of their stocks, because they're coming, going, sold, and so stock clerk. Clerical job, but stock. So he said, give me a stock clerk with a goal. He's a stock clerk, but he's got a goal. You give me a stock clerk with a goal, and I'll give you a man who will make history. On the other hand, you give me a person without a goal, and I'll give you a stock clerk. So he says, same person, at the age of 19, 20, what they are, two persons are there, one with a goal and one without a goal. The one with a goal will make history, or will, and it will make a success of his life. And this one will just drift along, like so many do it. Okay? That is the thing. So, what? Goal setting up maximizes your potential. We all have got good potential, we don't use it. Once we get focused in life and go for the things that we really want to have or to do, then results start coming. So this is called lifting the lid on yourself. You know, when you put a lid on something, nothing closes, it can't go. So if you put a lid on yourself, then you say, itna hi hoga, I cannot do. Then you're stuck here. You can, and that is all arbitrary. I cannot understand mathematics. Like, I've got my latest this thing. I can't understand computers. And what is there in computers? I don't have to be a Steve Jobs or a
programmer.
The children are doing computers, but you sell that idea to yourself that I can't do computers, or I cannot, I don't understand technical thing, whatever. Or I can't understand Sanskrit language. Whatever you put a lid on yourself. So goals help you to maximize your potential and lift up the lid. You make a goal that today you do not know computers, but by the end of December you will be knowing this many languages in computers. I will do that when it comes to specific goal. Then definitely you'll progress, because then your focus will completely come on that. So goals help you to lift your lid on yourself, to maximize your potential.
Get rid of limitations.
And goals give you the power to live in the present. Instead of thinking about what has gone or what is over, etc., you live in the present, you keep your priorities straight. And here is an important point. You focus on what is important. You focus on achievement and accomplishment and not on activity. Most of us,
activities,
we keep ourselves busy, and busyness is not progress. See, they say you must do things right. That is okay. But more important is, you must do the right things. Is this what I should be doing now? That is a question. I get up in the morning and I start doing some work, which has got no relevance to my goal in life, which has got no relevance to the problems I got. So I'm not progressing. So what is important is to identify the activities which are useful, which are productive, and fulfill them, and not get caught in busyness. They're very fond of, and I'm so busy, and from morning I'm working. Yeah, but what have you done? Now, I have to go from here to Mahim, and I start walking, and I'm walking towards Sasunda.
What I think, yes. Some homework should be done before proceeding the fulfillment of goal.
Yes, sure.
Because if you go in a wrong way, your goal will...
No, of course. You will not be
homework.
You will not be progressing towards your goal. Fully agree. That's true, correct. Thanks. Good point. So without goals, you tend to confuse busyness with activity. From morning, I've been working, cleaning my house. But actually, that's not what... And sometimes you keep yourself busy just to avoid the real work.
No.
What you have to do, in the office also you pick up something and all that, you know, just start checking something. But the real thing is something else. And you are not putting your heart into that. So you have to distinguish between activity and on the busyness and activity with accomplishment and achievement. That is important. Okay. Otherwise what happens, you know, there was a French scientist and he carried out one experiment with caterpillars. So he took a flower pot, the rims of he put the caterpillars all in one line, you know, that is round. And in such a way that the head capital was right ahead of the last capital, because it's the round. Okay. And caterpillars have a tendency to just keep going, keep following him. So they put that in the flower pot and let the caterpillars started moving around. And they kept on moving round and round and round and round. Not for 10 minutes or 15 minutes or 1 hour. They did it for 7 days. Until they died of starvation and exhaustion. With food right there, inches away the food was there. But they did not look here and there, they just went. So this is what happens. Then you say, "Maine itna kaam kiya hai, kuch hua nahi." But what did you do? Did you do the right thing?
Yes.
You know, that is most important. You don't do the right thing. Is this what you are supposed to do? Is this what you should do? You see? So that is another problem. When your goals are not clear, you might get confused between busyness and activity and outside and achievement and activation. You all have heard of Shiv Kera? He is a very well-known person in this field. In his book, he has given two examples of this type of, not being clear about the goals. What are the first example he gave? Anybody knows? Anita, you must keep books here for reference. Anybody know? Okay. A man was driving fast, very fast, his car. He's soon going this way. And his wife was sitting next to him and she told him, you know, in America everybody is honey and everybody is sweetheart. He said, "Honey, you're going the wrong way." And the man said, "Who cares? I'm covering a lot of distance." And the American language is something they're talking, it's like, "I'm making good time." That's the word he used. "I'm making good time. I'm covering a lot of distance." Okay. Who cares? So, you got the point? Okay, that is the first thing. And this is confusing activity with accomplishment. Yeah. So, I am going mine and I am going very fast, but in this direction, on this side. And you tell me...
No use.
No use. You are wasting petrol, country's petrol. Only of course now 1 paisa less in this period. So, that is his one example in here. Another example is that a man is there. He's got a dog, big dog, and whenever a car passes, have you seen dog? The dog is run, chase. Dog runs after the car, chases it, and the car goes away, because the car goes faster. That is what he does throughout the day, that dog. So one day his neighbor asks, "Why is he running so much after the dog? What will he, Is he ever going to catch a dog? He's not going to catch a car. He's not going to catch a car. So why is he running so much? So Shiv Kara says that that man replied, I am more bothered. I am not bothered about he catching the car. I am bothered about what he will do after catching the car. He will do nothing. What? Yeah. So these are meaningless goals. And we waste our time in meaningless goals. Usko dikhayega. Arey dikha ke kya karega tu? You have spent a lot of your time. Yeah. Okay, so this is about goals, keeping them. Now we come to next point. I take so much trouble not to come and speak to far more. So goals bring out the best qualities in you. Okay? Who will have goals in life? The person who has goals in life and works for others, he shows, he displays his desire to be better than what he is. He wants to make his today better than his yesterday and tomorrow better than today. Mm. Yeah, that is a, it shows that you have a desire and you want to be more productive, you want to improve your life and to achieve a lot. It means in short that you have a vision of, yeah. You know, 88, I don't know whether you have a vision or not. But you can always have a vision at any age. You know. It, you know, again, I said that the important things of life, we'll come to that, six important areas. His goal is definitely going to be different from my goal. He may be only, he may be an assistant manager and he may think of becoming general manager or chief manager or whatever. Anita will think how she's going to catch hold of a guy and take all his money. Anita, what is your goal in life? Your goal will be something else, no, that you'll have peace of mind, you can, your eyesight will be okay, your knees will not trouble you. Health will become a, perhaps the more important this thing. Or you go and see your life, Shirish is not there already, he went and to see his grandchild. That will be his goal, big goal. Okay. So goal will be there. So but if you have goals, it shows that you've got a desire to improve, to change, to do better, to make your life more interesting. Okay. Now, there are six major areas in a person's life. Can you tell me what are they? Can I help?
Personal, then social.
Social. I'll give you the answers afterwards, but yours will be matching here. Mm-hmm. What else? Social, personal?
Social, psychological. They want, after doing the activity, they want the, once they are getting the psychological satisfaction, their person is happy.
What else? Ditti, what is Ditti? Dipali, what do you call it? What other areas are there?
Financial,
yeah. We are all sitting here because you are financially okay. Now, you know, this tennis world champion Djokovic, today he has made a statement because they were talking about is it paining, you know, he got injured, his second title. And he said, what is this important, something like that, when there are children starving in the world. You see, what we are having our goal. Children are starving in the world and I think about, I have not got my pillow or I have not got my shirt or whatever it is. Or I should have got first prize but they gave it to him. They are all, isn't it? Okay, so health is that. Yeah. As you grow in life, you find health is most important. So the six important areas I have taken, something has been there. First and foremost, I would say physical and health. It's not in the order of missing, but physical and health. Second will be what? Quickly. Family and home. Family and home. Okay. Third will be professional and financial. Very important area. Fourth will be societal and cultural. No. Fourth I will put educational and mental. That is further education. Not you passed from college, etc. You got job, you entered profession. But you have to keep upgrading your skills, your knowledge. So that is educational and mental. Then fifth, as you said, societal and cultural. Mm. You want to be something in society, you know? Rotary club member, line club chairman, health library, whatever it is.
Social.
Yeah, something. Social. Yeah, you want that, this thing, you know? Secretary of your buildings, big society, secretary. Mm-hmm. These are all your goals also. They're an important part of your life. So how many become five? And last one is ethical and spiritual. That will come later on. Say, now his goals, most of them will be ethical and spiritual. I will not tell lies, I will not keep somebody's money, I will not do this, or I will do this, I will be kind, I will be generous, I will feed the poor, whatever it is. I want to be, now I will go to Rajneesh Ashram or wherever he is. Who is your favorite? Asaram Bapu. Wherever you want to go. Okay. So you got the six important areas. Now you can make slight changes, you can add something. What is the important point is that in all these areas you must set goals.
So, there should be
that is the... Otherwise, if you don't have goals and if you don't set goals, you might, your life might become too one-sided. You might give exaggerated importance or undue importance to one goal.
But that is what usually happens in life. Like we get carried away with one goal, so then we start neglecting either health or family.
I'll give a small advice. I don't give advice. From today, you stop using the word we and say I. I do this. I get distracted. Why do you want to be? Why do you want to take all of us with you? You improve yourself only. That is for all of us. I am lazy. Don't say we are lazy or we forget to take. So what you say is correct. I am like that only. So what were you saying?
Like we get carried away with one goal. So then we start neglecting or overlooking the other.
Yeah, that is what I am not talking about. You can see now what problems that people have heart attacks at the age of 20, 25, 30, blood pressure. Okay. Because they are giving too much importance to the profession, working day in, day out, night, sitting dinner. Families break up, divorces take place, children become addicted to drugs, etc. because there is no, both father and mother are working and going and coming late and socializing. Whatever it is, I'm not against any of these things. But this you can see for yourself. I have to decide for myself what I can do. Some people give too much importance to money, and everything is lost. So, now what happens is, supposing you can use this, no? On this I can, with this? Sure. I'm very bad. Okay, suppose this is you in the center, okay? Yeah? Now what is the first goal I told you, you wrote down?
Physical.
So physical and mental, no? You are up to this much in physical and mental. Okay? Then second?
Family.
Family and home. So you have here, not here. Okay. Family and home. Then?
Then financial.
Financial and professional. Then?
Education,
mental and education.
Mm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And last one, spiritual etiquette.
Mm.
Now you see, if you take like that, your life is balanced and well-rounded. And the drawing is not good. But supposing it was like that, what is your first goal? Health, physical and health. Okay. Second goal? Profession.
Mm.
No, third goal is family.
Whatever it is. Okay. Now you can see what is happening here.
Six.
It will go like this.
One is missing.
So this is your wheel of life. This will be balanced and it will roll more smoothly.
Mm.
Okay. Everything will go. Now, what goals are important for you? It will change from person to person. Please remember that. It's not that for everybody the same goals are most important. For you, health is more important than professional things or money. For you, professional things are more important. Okay, fine, doesn't matter. Okay. And for the same person also, the importance of each goal may change from time to time.
Time to time, yes.
So you are working also and you are studying also. Then when April may come and the exams are to come, then your goals will change. Now your focus will be entirely on getting that exam or getting the marks that is there. Okay. Or if there is wedding in the family, then you will have to take days off to another eldest member. So, but you have to, that's why when you do actually in detail in goals, you have to have, what do you say, review your goals. Every 3 months, 6 months, etc.
That's the main point.
Yeah. Whereas that is still your goal. Okay. So this is the six important areas. You got that now? Okay. Yes, ten.
Some goals are connected with the other persons also. If they don't cooperate with us, suppose our family life, happiness or peace of life. If other person in the family do not cooperate, that disturbs our happiness.
That will come on difficulties and obstacles in your life to achieve your goal. You have to take care of that, or you have to abandon your goal, or you have to be satisfied with less than. Yeah, I mean, that is not right. Yeah, wherever there are human beings, there are fight and
interest. But fulfilling our goal, I think so, that cooperation of the other persons also is
needed. Yeah, absolutely. But you have no control over that. You see, the whole idea about the goal is like is that you do what is in your control. I have no control over what you will do, or what you will think, and how you will react. Okay. Now,
in that situation, any remedy there?
No, I don't know. It will differ from situation to situation, what it is. First, you have to examine where you are at fault. Whether there is something that you can do to yourself to improve. That's a big thing. You have to go to life coaches and all that. And you can't talk in the air. If a situation is given, then we can think about it. But I would say not to be judgmental. Try to understand the other person's point of view. Try to see from his point of view. Very often we are blind to that. That is what I have realized. That we think that we are right always and the other person is wrong. Nobody is wrong all the time. Even there is a saying that even a broken clock shows the correct time. Twice in the 24 hours. It's something like that. Now, I went through this because I had a brother ahead. It was very, very difficult. It was really very difficult. But you have to keep track. If it is important for you, yeah. Okay. Now, we go to the next point of what goal is. Your goals should be smart goals. S-M-A-R-T. That is the acronym. What does SMART stand for? S is for specific. That's it. Be clear about what you say. Now if I say I want to earn a lot of money, that's not a good goal. But if I say I will have 1 million rupees in my bank account by 21st October, that is specific. Okay. So goal should be specific. Same thing about them. I'm going to get very good marks in the examination. That's not a goal. I'm going to get 95% marks. That becomes specific. Okay. So it should be specific goal. Okay. Then L is S for specific. Go to the next one.
M
for measurable. You know, we are talking about smartphones. Now we are talking about smart goals. So M is measurable. You should be able to measure your. Otherwise, if you are not able to measure, then it's no use. Suppose I say I want to be a fantastic speaker, it means nothing. What is fantastic is no use. Or I want to be the ideal husband. Or I want to be the best daddy in the world. Every father wants to be that. Best daddy in the world or whatever. So these are not specific goals, these are not measurable goals. You know, there is a story of a swimmer, a real life story of a swimmer, Lady Chadwick, her name was. She was from the English Channel and all that. She was swimming the Catalina Channel. And there was a lot of fog. There was so much of fog that you could not see anything. So she could not cross it, she had to give up. And Chadwick gave up not because she was a quitter, but because she could not measure how much distance is left. And it seemed later on, while after the event, that she was only a short way away. And she said, I'm not making excuses, but if I could see the land, If I could see my goal, I would have definitely been able to. Yeah? So, if it is a goal is measurable, then it is a good goal. Otherwise, it's a specific, measurable. Third is, what is third, Mr.? A is what? Attainable. I should feel that I can attain this goal. If I stretch myself very much, I can attain this goal. I can reach this. Suppose you and I decide to walk from here to the other. I mean, it's difficult. But you see that it's possible. Okay, 7-8 kilometers. But if you have to walk by before tomorrow reach Himalaya, then you won't even start. If it takes such a stupid goal, you won't even start because you yourself will internally not feel that you can achieve it. So it's important that you choose goals which are attainable. In that you keep in mind your past also. How would you keep in mind your past? As an example, suppose if a student is getting only 35% mark and he suddenly makes a goal and get 95% mark, it's not likely it goes wrong. It may not be attainable. Okay. So, what is my past? I walk so slowly and often I walk 100 kilometers in one day or whatever it is. So attainable, but the goal should be a challenging goal. Only then it will bring out the best in you. It should be challenging goal, it should be a stretch goal. Yeah. Only then it will motivate you. Then next is R. R is realistic. It is akin to practical, but it is something which is not in your control. Realistic means there is nothing in the outside world which will prevent you from achieving the goal. Now for example, I make a goal, I know, because you, a person who is 40 years old, makes a goal that I want to become an IAS officer. I want to join the IAS service. Okay. Can you do it? Can you do it? 40 year old man. Why?
Engagement.
Age limit.
Who has the limit? IAS?
The government.
Okay. So there are laws of the country don't permit you. It is, they are clear that the maximum age to, for entry is 30 years or 25 years or whatever it is. So then I can make such a goal. I may have the ability, I may have a very strong desire, I may have the ability to become. Maybe I will be better than most of the IAS officers. But I cannot become an IAS officer. Okay. So that is realistic. And last is what?
T.
T is what? Time bound. The goal should be time bound. You must fix time limit for the achievement of a goal. Otherwise, it's not a goal at all. One example of a goal with the time limit was John F. Kennedy, President of America, he declared that our goal is to put a man on the moon by 31st December. Very specific, 31st is the date. Suppose we will put a man on the moon very soon. Now what is very soon? It can be 1 year, it can be 10 years, it can be 2 days. See, this is specific. By 31st December or by the end of year, we will put a man on the moon. So where will we put him? We will put a man very high up. We will put him on the moon. And that is a specific goal. Such goals have more chances of being achieved. Another simple one is, which is my goal, I will reach a weight of 68 kg by the end of October, by the end of December. That becomes a specific, time-bound goal. Okay. I may not achieve it. I'm just giving an example. I have got this, that by end of December I will reduce a little bit, not exactly. Okay. But that is a time-bound goal. So it is very important that you specify your time frame. So if you make a saying that I want to reach turnover of 20 million, that is not a goal. But if you say that turnover of my company will become 10 million by the
31st March.
Yeah, fine. Okay, fine. Now in addition to being written goals, your goals must be flexible.
Just
as you grow, your goals also should change and grow. That is what is important. As you grow, you should also grow. Why am I saying this is because don't become the slave of a goal. Goals are your slave, you are not the slave of goal. You have intelligence, you may have to change the goal. You have to modify your goal, etc. So, your goal should be flexible. Let's take a small example. Suppose a student is now in 9th standard or 8th standard and he has got only 35% marks in his final exam. Or 38 or 40. Okay, now nowadays nobody gets 35, no?
Mm.
Now today somebody said that the marks are 98.5, 97.6. So the mark sheet is a temperature sheet. So nowadays it is. Okay, so suppose this student is getting only say 38% marks. And he makes a goal now that is from 8 years past, the final year over and come to 9. He says, in the 9th final exam result, I will have 50% marks. Good, modest step, not 50% he said, I will. Now, but he started studying, etc. So by the time he had his terminal, he reached 60%. In his terminal, he got 60% marks. Now, is this not a case for changing his goal? He had made a goal for 50% final, he has already reached 60, and 6 months are left for study. So you can change it to 70 or 80 or whatever. You can make it flexible. Okay. Take another example. A man has achieved 10 million tons output. Okay. This year. 10 million tons. And now he has made a goal of achieving 18 million tons. Okay. For this financial year, this calendar year. And now what happens is that 6 months are over and he has achieved only 3 million. Last year was 10, goal is 18, and now 6 months away he has achieved only 3 million tons. Not because of his fault, now I am going to your point. The fault is there's economic meltdown in the country, demonetization has taken place, recession has happened, war between India and Pakistan has broken out, or whatever reason it is, all this reason is. Output is only 3 million. So now is a change case for changing his goal. So flexible goals need not be only upward, they can also be downward. You are the best judge of it. Therefore, it is very important when it came to your point that you review your goals every 3 months, 6 months. Am I on the right track? Am I going the right speed? Etc. Is this still my goal? You come to that. Okay, so that is. So your goal must be, what did I say first, time bound, then this must be, what did we say now, flexible. Third, next point is, your goal should be your own goal, your personal goal, not somebody else's goal. I want to become a general manager, but my father wants me to become a general manager, or my wife is telling me to buy that house in Ghatkopar. I wanted. Okay. You should feel strongly about what you want. Only then you will have that motivation. You will have the courage to face difficulties. And you will also have the stamina to work for it. So it's important that your goals are your own goals, your personal goals. Okay. Next is your goals should be stated in positive terms. That is, you must state, always state what you want to happen in your life and not what you don't want. Most of us are concentrating more on what we don't want in life. I don't want to be ill. No, I want to be healthy. That is a better goal, not I don't want to be ill. So, state goals in positive terms. And lastly, the goals should be written goals. Reduce your goals in writing. Okay? That's most important to write a goal. You cannot overemphasize the importance, the desirability of writing down a goal. In American government, they took a statistic and they found 3% of the population in America is rich, very rich, so rich that they can get whatever they want in life. And they need not go to work unless they want to work. They need not work at all. 3%. 10% of the population have got well-defined goals, okay, and they are independent, they are financially well-off, doing well for themselves, but they have to work, they are not everywhere. And 10% of people are like that. Then 60%, the large chunk like you and me, middle class as you call here, the last important 60%, they have goals, but goals are vague and not well-defined. And they move from check to check. Like we always say, at the end of the month, people are looking at when is salary coming. You know, when I joined first out of college and I went, I never talked about money, I didn't know. In the first month, I was at a project doing administrative work. I was surprised that the salary was delayed, according to them, by 2 days. They were not doing any work, they were miserable, they were all the time looking out of the window, phoning up, paisa coming in the car. And then I realized that money is only important. Even Tendulkar does not live for the country, he plays for all the name, fame and money that he gets. That is not the country to hold in my eyes. Okay, so 60% are like that, from check to check. So how many become? 3 plus 10, 13 plus 6, 60, 83, 27 I mean?
70.
60 and 10, 73, so 27 remain. Oh. 27 persons have got no goals at all. Or if at all there were any goals, they are survival goals. They cannot get along on their own, they need some government assistance, etc. The important point here is, the difference between the 3% and 10%, now both are independent, both are, difference between 3% and 10% is that the 3% have put their goals in writing. And these people are not motivated. That is the
importance of writing.
Effect of writing. Writing goals increases the commitment. You know, anything in writing, if I give you word of mouth that I'll give you 5,000 rupees tomorrow, it means one thing. If I give you in writing and if I give you a check, it means something else. So you increase your commitment when you write, okay? Then goals help you, written goals help you to measure your progress. And they serve as constant reminders that you have to do this, you have to do this. They keep you on track. And this is important, I am telling you. Written goals help you to clarify and crystallize your ideas. Write down the main point. Written goals help you another 5 minutes more? I'm going by my watch. Eh? There's 7 minutes more coming by my watch. So, yeah.
You can proceed.
Huh? You can proceed. Yeah, writing down
that right. Written goal helps?
Written goal help you
clarify.
Or force you to clarify and crystallize your thoughts or crystallize your thinking. Which in turn helps you to develop definite plans of action clarify and crystallize the thinking which helps you to develop definite plans of action and definite plans of action give you results. Plan of action will be definite, that will give you results. An indefinite plan gives you little or no result. The person who said this, his name is Paul Meyer. So, the last point why written goals are important is that most of our goals are not out of reach, they are out of sight. To forget it. Now today you make a goal that I am going to do this, etc. But tomorrow morning you forget it, because you are so busy. You get involved in activity. But if you write it down somewhere, you see it taken. So these are the advantages of writing it. So what is the whole purpose in this 1 hour we talked about? What is the whole purpose of goal and goal setting? It is to improve your life, to take you from where you are to where you want to go. Okay? And,
To have the better tomorrow.
See, suppose you want to go from A to B. What do you do? First, you have to know where you are. And you travel by this thing. So, Uber and Ola and Uber and all. The moment they come, they ask you where you want to go. And they have that map, the location. So that is the way you start. Where am I at present? Where I want to go? And then am I moving in the right direction? From time to time you ask. Especially the
right.
So from when you have to go from A to B, first you know where you are, where you want to go, and then time to time you check whether B is still your goal or you want to change it. You know, frankly, you get an idea of it. So your goals that way can be short-term goals. Say up to 1 year will be short-term, 3 years will be mid-term, and up to 5 years will be okay. So the importance of, I'll just read this out to you. We are going to do a goal setting exercise for 2 minutes. Now that is practically that you can take from here, in addition to So we'll say this, the importance and purpose of goal setting is to guide you, motivate you in your quest for a better life. The purpose and importance of goal setting is to guide you, to motivate you in your quest for a better life, in your journey from wish to fulfillment. You are going to just not just wish, you are going to fulfill. So goals help you to set your future. Okay. How will you follow? Write the goal. It's a very simple step. First, write down your goals. Don't write too many goals out. To impress somebody, don't do that. You write 3-4 goals. If one goal is very important, write only one goal. Doesn't matter. Okay. So write down your goals. First is what goal you would like to achieve in as clear terms as possible. You write it down and put a time in it. Time factor. That is important. Without time factor, there will be no goal as well. Okay, then you write down what action you can take immediately. What action you can take immediately. Don't postpone taking action, that's important. Immediately or within 7 days. I'll tell you for example, supposing you make a goal of becoming fitter. Okay, and you write, I'll go to gym. I'll go 5 days in a week to the gym. And I will do exercise. And my goal is to reduce by weight from 80 kgs to 75 kgs or 70 kgs of weight. So what can you do immediately whilst I'm talking to you? Now suppose I made this goal, what can I do? I can immediately do some push-ups, I can do some stretching, I can take a walk. Immediately, I don't have to wait till tomorrow morning. So what happens is the process starts. And very often you know in life, the starting is only most difficult. Mm-hmm. You keep on putting it off. Okay, so put your goals in writing, put a time limit. To see what action you can immediately take. Okay. Then third is write down what additional knowledge, knowledge, skills, ability you will need to achieve your goal. Three, begin. Four, list out the people who can help you, who you think can help you. You want to go abroad now, who will help me? Yeah, you know Shirish. Shirish has just gone and come. He'll tell you where to go for your passport, where to go for your visa, where to go for your tickets, which are the countries, which are the time. Who can help you? What do you think? Okay. Then fifth one is determine the obstacles that you will meet. Obstacles that you will meet. Okay. You'll have to overcome them for the achievement of your goal. So whatever obstacles will be there, you've got a sick grandmother at home, so you can't put the light on after 10 o'clock to study. An obstacle maybe. Okay. I think we're going home now.
It's okay, let me tell you.
My lecture is worth 1 lakh. If you pay me 10,000, I'll give you a lecture. Okay. Laugh at it. Okay, so where are we? So what are the obstacles? It could be your health, it could be that there's going to be a wedding in the family. Mm-hmm. There'll be a lot of disturbances, there will be a lot of other activities. Whatever it is, or my father is under transfer order, I mean I have to change locale, etc. So whatever difficulties you envisage, put it down. And what steps you will take, how will you get over it, etc. Unless you think about it, you will not do it, okay? Sixth, very important, write a paragraph or write a page on why you are absolutely committed to achieve your goal. How important that goal is to you. Write it down. I must. And the more reasons you give, the stronger will be your motivation. If I do this, my girlfriend will fall in love with me. Or if I do this, etc., my wife will be so happy. My children's school will be happy. I will get an increment or I will get a promotion. My health will be good. Whatever it is, write down. And after this, the real hard work is make a detailed plan. Make a detailed plan for what you're going to do, when, where. Break it down activity-wise and put proper time for it. So you have to go abroad and activity-wise, so this is what I will do in this one, this is what I will do for examination. Because smaller goals are easier to achieve than big goals. So you break them into small goals. There's a saying in America, different people say it differently. There's a Gordon who says, by the yard. By the yard, it is hard. Or life is hard by the yard. By the inch, it is a cinch. Cinch means it's definite. So you know what's a yard? 3 feet. So by the yard, gone. Why is it gone? By the yard, it is hard. So suppose you decide to walk up to Mahim and you look at it and it will look very far. But suppose you break it down and now we go with half an hour, we'll reach Ajali. So Ajali becomes a smaller goal. And then when you reach Ajali, it says, let's have a cup of tea, etc. And then you walk up to Gurli, Prabhadi. No, Prabhadi is very far, Gurli. Gurli Naka or Sri Sai or Deru Planetary. Then again, there I will have Vada Pong or something like that, etc. And then we make a goal to walk up to Shivaji Park. However, Mahim will become. I do it every morning. When I get tired and I'm coming here from a walk, I say, how to walk, take a taxi or, you know, I'll walk at least up to there and we'll see. So by the time you go there, you know, I think I'll walk up to there also. So that way you achieve something.
You take the big goal if you...
The small goal, yeah. By the yard, the big goal remains.
Yeah,
it remains.
You hear
me. By the yard, it is hard.
By the inch.
By the inch. Yard means 3 feet. It is
small.
Use a bigger
word.
Cinch means definite. It's bound to happen, something like that it is. So this is all that. Thank you. So you can ask me any questions, you can talk.